Solve. X minus 3 equals the square root of 3x plus 19. We call this a radical equation because it has a radical in it, and it's the square root, the second root. So to get rid of that radical, we can square each side, raise each side to the second power. So let's show us doing that. X minus 3, this is not x squared minus 9. This is x minus 3 times x minus 3, which then becomes x squared minus 6x plus 9 equals, well, the square of the square root of something is just that radicand, what is under the radical. So 3x plus 19. Okay, now we've got an equation to solve. It's a quadratic equation, symbolized by this square here, the power of 2. And we want to get all of the everything on one side, get it in standard form. So let's subtract a 3x from each side and subtract a 19 from each side. And then I'll write the result. And that is x squared minus 9x minus 10 equals 0. Now this quadratic equation is in standard form. Now you could solve this using the quadratic formula or completing the square. This looks easy enough to factor, so I'm just going to factor this one. We start out, lay down our format here, equals 0, two numbers that multiply to equal 10. I know this so happens to be x plus 1 and x minus 10. 1 times negative 10 is negative 10, 1 plus negative 10 equals negative 9. So that's the way we factor that. After you factor that quadratic, you set up your mini equations, that is x plus 1 equals 0. You also have x minus 10 equals 0. So we're looking for both of those. Solving, subtract 1 from each side, and you have x equals negative 1. That's one of the solutions. The other one is x equals 10. Okay, so we have our two solutions. And these are definitely solutions to this equation, to this quadratic equation. But something interesting happens when you take the square, or square each side, to solve for a radical equation. You may get what's called an extraneous solution. So we need to check these and make sure they don't give extraneous solutions. So without the red, that is just the original equation here. So I'm going to plug in x equals negative 1 in for x here and see if that is a solution. So I have negative 1 minus 3 equals, and I put a little question mark saying, does it equal the square root of 3 times negative 1 plus 19? It's the square root of all of that. Negative 1 minus 3 is negative 4, and the square root of negative 3 plus 19, that's the square root of 16. So negative 4, that does not equal 4. So we're going to cross this out. This is called an extraneous solution. So even though it solved what we had, remember, it's a solution to our modified equation, this thing in yellow. It is not a solution to the original equation. Okay, to save some time, I'll let you plug in 10 in for x and see that that is a solution. So our solution is just x equals 10. We have just one solution for this equation.